I've now been using Windsor & Newton Promarkers for about 2 years, and in today's video I'm going to give you my honest opinions on them so that you can make an informed decision whether they're right for you. And to do this, I'm going to be colouring in this Rolls-Royce Ghost, so yeah, let's just dive straight into the video. Now before I can actually go and hit this with the alcohol markers, I firstly need to go around it with a kneadable eraser to remove any of the excess graphite, because at the moment these lines are really quite dark, and if I go over them with the alcohol markers then the ink will seal the graphite, and then I'll end up with loads of really dark lines showing through in the final result, which we do not want. So now we've just covered that, let's look at actually reviewing the Windsor & Newton Pro markers, and I want to start off with the downsides. However, there are plenty of upsides as well to these markers, so make sure you stick around to the end so you do not miss them. So starting off with the most obvious thing that people will notice when they come to buy these markers, the price. They are by no means the cheapest marker on the market. You're looking at around £1.50 all the way up to £3.65 per marker, dependent on which size set you get and where you get them from. So it's all very well and good me standing here whinging about the price, but if I'm being honest, they do come in a nice case. They feel professional in terms of the quality of the marker. And yeah, you are kind of paying for the Windsor & Newton brand because it is a professional brand. And at the end of the day, professional art supplies are never cheap. So moving on to the next downside of these markers, it's that the color on the wrap often isn't the color that you get from the marker. I would always recommend testing the marker on a scrap piece of paper before going into your drawing so that you're not left with any nasty surprises. Now the next downside is that the color vibrancy that you get isn't necessarily as bright as some of its competitors' brands, because I've tested some cheaper markers as well recently, and this BMW for instance, the right hand side was done with really cheap markers and the left hand side was done with pro markers, and you can just see that the right hand side is just a bit more vibrant. However, if you look a bit closer you can see that the blending on the left hand side with the pro markers is just a heck of a lot better than the cheaper markers. So my absolute final moan about these markers is the fact that they obviously have a bullet nib and also a chisel tip, but in my opinion the bullet nib isn't actually that sharp in comparison to other different markers that I've tried. However, you can easily get around this by using the sharper edge of the chisel tip, and I shouldn't really be moaning because they also have an upgraded version from the Pro Marker called the Pro Marker brush that has like the Copic brush tip with a really really sharp point, so you are able to go into those really small details with those upgraded markers. A quick interruption to this video, I have a super exciting announcement. If you would like to learn how to draw like me completely for free, so you'd like to learn my method of sketching using graphite pencils, how I use alcohol markers, how I use colored pencils, I now have a free drawing course linked down in the description, and yeah, it's completely free and you will learn everything that I know about drawing that I've learned in the past 5 years. So with that said, let's just get straight back to the video. So that is the end of me absolutely slating the Pro Markers. So let's actually get on to the good stuff, starting off with the fact that the Pro Marker range comes with 189 different colors. Now you may be thinking that some cheaper markers come with like 365 different colors, but what you're forgetting is the fact that these Windsor & Newton Pro Markers are absolutely insane at blending. So you can put one color down, then you can put another color on top of this, and you can create an entirely new color. So with these 189 different colors, you can create like an infinite number of colors. So with the Pro Marker range, you're never going to be short on colors. The markers are also insanely well built, and I've been using some of them for a very long time, and the tips are still nice and hard, because what can happen with cheaper markers is as you're using the markers, the tips become softer and mushy because they're made of cheaper, nastier materials. And something that is more of a personal preference is I really like the shape of these markers, because some other marker brands, they get really creative with like the shape of the body of the marker. They do like hexagonal ones, like weird rectangular ones, and just they get a bit crazy. However, these Pro Markers are nice and simple, and for some reason I like that. Maybe it's because I'm simple. Now this kind of brings us on to the end of the video, and you're probably wondering now, so are these markers actually for me? And that really does depend what you're wanting to use them for. You see, I use alcohol markers as a base layer for colored pencils to go on top of, and this is because when colored pencils go on top of a colored surface they're a lot more vibrant than if they were going on top of a white surface, and this is the reason that I'm actually thinking of downgrading to a cheaper marker brand like something like Ohuhu or something similar, because I just don't need that extreme blending ability of the Windsor & Newton Pro Markers. And by what I mean is that the Pro Markers are basically too good for what I want them for. But if you're going to be doing more cartoony stuff like anime or comic books, then I definitely would recommend them, because obviously the marker work is going to be more on display because you're not covering it up, so you can really utilize that amazing blending ability of the markers. So yeah, thank you so much for watching till the end of this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you have, please hit that subscribe button, and I shall hopefully see you in this video right here. This one right here. Go click it.